All right, got a new cardiologist in town, Dr. David Young, Barton Cardiology.
That's right.
Which did not exist before you got here.
It did not exist as of
January.
Yeah, it's hard to believe. But as of January 1st, we have a full-time cardiology program here at Barton.
Yeah. So that's a heart specialist, basically.
I am a heart specialist. I handle things like coronary artery disease, heart failure, heart arrhythmias, you know, abnormal heart rhythms. Mm-hmm. High blood pressure, high cholesterol, you know, the whole gamut of heart disease we can handle at Barton.
Good. It's so hard for me to even imagine that we didn't have a cardiology program at Barton before you came, so thanks.
Well, you're very welcome.
I mean, you're bound to save some people around here, because we're kind of isolated here in Tahoe, like with snow conditions and that sort of thing, that I know in the past, if there was an issue, a serious issue, life-threatening issue, we had to fly them somewhere else.
That's true. I mean, very commonly someone would have a heart condition. You, thank gosh you have CalSTAR up here, which is such a great resource for you. But you would have to be flown to either Reno or Carson City for your care. And my goal up here is to do as much as we can up here so the patient doesn't have to be transferred.
Yeah.
But I think at the same token, some conditions do require you to have a higher level of care, and we're working on...
Well, it's good you see that and be like, hey, you know what? You need to go to the other place.
mainly for procedures, advanced procedures. But for 99% of the cardiac care, we're hoping we can handle that right here at Barton.
And the cool thing, too, is I know you grew up around here, went to school around here. Your dad's still in the area. Yep. Talk a little bit about that.
Right, yeah. So I graduated from University of Nevada, Reno in 2000 with my Bachelor of Science of Biochemistry. Stayed on through 2004 and obtained my medical degree, and then went to Scripps Clinic down in San Diego to do my cardiology training and came back to the area to work. So,
damn, that sounds like a lot of school work.
It was a lot
of
school.
Holy cow. So wait, you must be psyched now to just be like applying yourself.
Yeah, it's great.
Especially back in the community that you grew up in, your dad's here.
It feels great. Yeah, I know. We're really excited about it.
Barton's kind of blowing my mind. I just keep seeing them add more and more programs. This seems to be another one. And
oh, they're adding all kinds of programs.
It's really awesome.
Yeah, they just brought a physician in from the Mayo Clinic on the orthopedic side.
Yeah.
They have an audiology program that they're working on building, and now cardiology. The administration at Barton is really dedicated to this community and providing quality health care.
I know since I was a kid, it seems like we've all become much more educated through public awareness of the things you can do to take care of yourself, take care of your heart. Just touch on some of those real obvious, the no smoking.
You know, a part of cardiology is not rocket science. I mean, there are several risk factors that you have to recognize to prevent heart disease. And high blood pressure is one of them, which you may not have symptoms from, but your doctor can monitor your blood pressure and diagnose
that. And that can be hereditary?
That can be hereditary, a very strong hereditary pattern to that. High cholesterol, which you see on your annual blood work, diabetes, obesity, which is becoming an epidemic in this country, we need to recognize. Smoking is probably the worst.
Mm-hmm. Does it matter what you're smoking? In California
I think that cigarette smoking is what's clearly linked with heart disease. Marijuana smoking, I don't think we have definitive studies as to the long-term cardiovascular health consequences of that.
And the drinking.
Is obviously a huge piece. You know, alcohol has a weird sort of cardiology
relationship. You hear these things where they say, well, have just a little bit and you're going to be okay. Have too much and you're going to die.
Yeah, and you know, we first thought it was red wine because that was sort of have these anti-inflammatory medicine in it. Turns out it doesn't really matter what alcohol it is. If it's, you know, about one, at most two drinks a day, that can sort of relax your blood vessels and even lower blood pressure, and it can also raise your good cholesterol, what's called your HDL. Mm-hmm. Once you exceed that, though, then the effects of alcohol almost become harmful. You know, the next day, your blood pressure rises.
You can feel it when you drink too much.
That's not good.
Yeah.
But certainly a small amount of alcohol for the right patients is beneficial.
I like your style. You seem like you'd be an easy doctor to talk to. Real quick, I know we're a little bit short on time, but I wanted to touch on this telemedicine program. I know you do it. What is it?
Telemedicine is a really interesting field that is developing. So in a lot of these smaller communities who may not have access to a specialist, we can now do consultations over the internet. So you can have a physician who's wherever, a top physician in his specialty, that can have a central base and then monitors in other areas, and you can do a full patient interaction over the internet.
I like it.
We're working on building that. Certainly California is excited about that. I think it's a great aspect of medicine, and so that program's going to grow.
Yeah. And then I know you have a lecture coming up the 1st of February. Yeah. I mean, is this the kind of thing like, Like, I hear you have election coming up, and I'm not going. I feel like I'm doing good. Is somebody like me need to go, or is this for somebody that goes, man, my heart's hurting, I'd better go see what's going on?
No, I think this is not going to be a technical mumbo-jumbo talk. My goal for this is to meet with the members of the community and just let them know, what are risk factors for heart disease? You know, what is high blood pressure? Mm-hmm. What may you be feeling? Are you feeling chest pains? And just sort of help bring heart education into the community.
I like it. Well, it's really nice to meet you, Dr. Young, new cardiologist in town. I'm sure it's a good thing for Barton to have a heart specialist in the town.
No, we're very excited about it, and thank you for this opportunity.
Yeah, we'll come back in and talk a little bit more, and welcome back to town, because I know you spent a lot of time here, you know, throughout your years. So, new cardiologist in town, Dr. David Young, Barton Cardiology. Thank you for watching us here on Lake Tahoe Television's Tahoe Today. We'll be back bright and early first thing tomorrow morning at 7 o'clock with more of Lake Tahoe Television's Tahoe Today. Outside TV's up next. Whew, get out there. Don't waste a day. I can feel it in my heart.
Yeah.
And we'll see you back here tomorrow. Thanks for watching. Okay.